In this video, we'll be using WPForms to create a free form on our WordPress website. Let me show you what we'll be learning in this tutorial. We're going to walk through all the different fields of WPForms. To create this amazing form with all the fields available, I'm going to show you how you can put fields in different kind of column structures. We're going to add reCaptcha to our form. We're going to set up email notifications the right way. We're going to change the confirmations so that they actually work and look great. Then we're going to show you a way to save all the entries completely free and it works like a charm. And of course, how to style your WPForms without buying any upgrade or touching any code. Let's dive in right now. Log into your WordPress dashboard. If you're still using WP Admin, that's not a very safe way, so please watch my tutorial about securing your WordPress website because you don't want to get hacked. Then we go to Plugins, Add New over here, and then type in over here WP Forms. We're going to look for this cute little bear and press Install Now. After that, we press Activate, and here we are. Welcome to WP Forms. The first thing we do is we scroll down, create your first form. And we're going to press on Let's Go. And we press Done. WP Forms is really proud of all their templates, and they should be because there are 628 templates available. That's insane. Anything you want to do, if for example a dentist form, for example a bid form, it's already there. An auction item request form, it's all inside of this plugin. However, you need the pro version. So I'm just going to show you how we can create our own form. Click on create blank form over there. Press done over here. Press done again. And then we're going to press the cross icon over here and close this one also. Thank you very much. Let's work distraction free. So we're going to press on this cross icon over here like this. Well, now we are at notifications, but this is not the place to start. So let's go back to setup over here. And then we're going to name our form Learn WP Forms. And then we go to fields down here. On your fields, you can see all the fields that are available in this plugin. We're using the free version, so all these fancy fields, we're not going to use this one. We're going to close this one and we're going to close this one. In this video, we're going to talk about all these standard fields available within our form. The first thing we're going to create is you go to name and drag it and drop it over there. Here you go. This is a name field. Really nice. First name, last name. If you now click on it, then you can edit it over there. We have the label. Let's change this to what is your name. Then you can choose the format. In our case, I want to have the first and last. Let's go to advanced over there. Then you can change the field size. Let's keep this one on large. Then you can also add a placeholder to the first name like this. Matt, and the last one should be the W Prince Doctor. You can use this, however, I don't advise you to do so because your name is actually really logical. You don't need any help to fill this out. All right, let's go back to add fields over here. Check out the email field. We're gonna put it in over there, just drop it, click on it, and then we're gonna change the label to what is your email. Of course, it's required. And if you click on enable email confirmation, you will see another field popping up, which says confirm email. In this way, the chances that they fill out a wrong email address are really small. Then we go to advanced. Again, you can change the field size, placeholder. And the fun thing to use here is a default value. If you use with people who are logged into your website, you can actually click on show smart tags and you can add a default value. For example, if you scroll down, it should be the user email over here. So when someone is logged into your website, it will automatically fill in. If they're not logged in, it will not show like this. I am logged into my website, so my email address is this. Let's go back to add fields. Then we're gonna add a drop down over there. Let's drop it over here. And then we're gonna change this one. You can add in a label, and then you have drop downs in your form. If you go to advanced, you can also do multiple options selection over here. Now people can choose multiple answers to your question. Now what I want to do is I want this dropdown to have it next to my email. How do I do that? Well, select this dropdown, press on advanced, go to show layouts. Here we're gonna pick on this column over here, choose which side it is. This is the right side. And then we go to this field. And again, go to Advanced, Show Layouts. I want two columns, and this one is the left one. Click on it, and we're gonna press Save. And now it is like this. What is your email, and have you already subscribed? And now I see that these fields are not equally sized. How do we change that? We go to the Advanced, and we're gonna make the field size to large, and also, have you already subscribed? Go to Advanced and make it large. Now it will use the full width of my page, so this looks great. Get back to Add Fields. We can also add, of course, checkboxes, like this. Click on it. And the fun thing is, you can also use image choices over there. And you can upload images to all of your choices. Really nice. Just press on Upload Image over here. And choose the image that fits your choice. And do it again with the other one. Once you have added them in, you will see this notification. Images are not cropped or resized, 250 width and height pixels or smaller. You can also change the style a little bit. Modern like this, a little bit more classic or none. But let's use modern, I like this. You can also choose icon choices, press continue. And when it's done, you can press OK. And it will be refreshed. Click on again over here. And if you now scroll up, we can change the icons. In our case, I like the image choices way better, of course. You can make this field again required, so they have to make a choice. Then we go to Advanced, and here you can actually randomize the choices, which is really neat. We have WPForms on top, Elementor, and then a small Divi. And if I press on Preview again, now we can see Divi on top, and then WPForms, and then Elementor. And here you can also make the choice layout in one column, two columns. In our case, three columns would be best. There is a bit of scaling done now because we now have set the width of the three columns. Here you can actually limit the choices to, for example, you can only pick two of them. And then you can also hide the label over there. And then you can also enable a disclaimer terms of service display. If you click over here, you will see this box over there. You can fill this in later on, but you can use it just to accept the terms of service. Let's get back to add fields. What you can also do is a number slider. Nice. Put it in. If we click on it, we can change the label. And then we have 1 to 10, which is great. If we now go to Advanced, you can also select the default value. So let's put this on an 8. You can also change the increment. With that, they mean the steps. If the steps are 1, you can also change it to 0.5. Now, when I'm sliding this, you'll see the value dropping down with steps of 0.5. Let's get back to add fields. And then we can also add a paragraph text. The most boring field, but one of the most important fields. Because now people can actually give you feedback. If you click on it, you can just add a paragraph text. But change the title to, for example, your question. And we're gonna make it required. If you go to advanced, now here you can change the field size. But in this case, it is already full width. So the only thing you can change is the height of this field. Small, medium, or large. Let's keep it on medium. And then we're gonna limit the length. I only want to have 500 characters, or else it's gonna be way too much to read. You can also choose to hide this label, but I want it to be shown. All right, let's get back to add some more fields. And we can also add a multiple choice in there. Wow. If you click on it, you can change the label again. And then you can just add in all these answers. And again, you can also use images and you can also use icons. So let's use icons. Now we have icons to our answers. And if you scroll down, you can also change the color of them. So let's change the color in this case. Let's change the color to red. And then you can change the icon size. Make it medium, make it small. Let's keep them all large, why not? And you can change this to modern, classic, none, or default, but I like the modern even better. Gonna make it required. If we go to advanced, we can make it randomized, but in this case, this is way better. And we can make it inline or three columns or two columns. In this case, we have four options. So I would choose to say it to keep it on two columns or inline. If we make it on two columns, this is how it looks. All right, let's add in the last two fields. The last one is a number. And the number, if you click on it, is actually a number field. just like this. And it's also required, and press on advanced, you can change the field size. I would make this small because it's just such a small number. And then we're gonna add the last field, which is a captcha. If you want to add in the captcha, if you click on it, this is what it says. Heads up, the captcha settings has not been configured yet. Before we can use the captcha, we have to go to settings over here, and then you can go to spam protection and security over there. You click on reCaptcha, but nothing works right now. So what are we gonna do is we're gonna save this one, press on this cross icon, close this one again. We're gonna close the upsell also. And then we go on the left side, we go to settings over there, and then we go to captcha over here, right there. Click on reCaptcha right there, and we scroll down. The first thing we can do is choose a checkbox, reCaptcha version 2 invisible or reCaptcha version 3. Well, I like the checkbox a little bit better, but if you notice a lot of spam, then try to switch to reCaptcha version 3. Where to get a side key and secret key? Just open up a new tab and type in Google reCaptcha. Then we click on the first result, and you might have to log into Google. Then we click on the V3 admin console over there. And the first thing we do is register a new site. Well, type in the label of your website, in this case, wpressdark.com. Just choose the version you would like. Let's go with reCaptcha version 2. And then I want a checkbox. Why not add a domain in? The domain should be exactly the same, or else it doesn't work. Add in the owner, well, it's from your Google account. Accept the terms and service, of course. And then we press submit. Now we get a side key, copy it, paste it in over here. Also with the secret key, paste it in over there. And then we press save and settings. Well done, settings were successfully saved. Then we go back to all forms. And in here, we can edit again our form we have just created. You want to drag it, but you can't. You have to click it. And then it says, been enabled for this form. Don't forget to save it. Save it, press preview. And now you will see that the reCaptcha, it has been entered. Wow, it's amazing. The only problem I have, without CSS, you cannot change the position of this reCaptcha checkbox. But hey, it's a free plugin, so if that's all. Well done, now you have seen all the fields available to us in the free version of WP Forms. If you want to place this form on our website, you just press on embed over there. If you want to embed it in a page, you just click on embed your form manually or use a shortcode. We're gonna use a shortcode, so we're gonna press copy, this one, press close. Then you leave this editor over here. We go to pages, all pages. We go to our contact page within Divi in this case. In this case, I'm just gonna add in a new text module over there. Go to the text editor, place it in here and press save. And when I now exit my visual builder, I have it embedded on my website like this. On your dashboard, if you go to WPForms, you go to all forms, you can see all the forms you have created. You can duplicate them just like that. But what I want to show you is the notifications. So we press on edit. And then we go over here to settings, and then we go to notifications right there. In the free version of WP Forms, we can only add one notification. We're gonna add a notification to, of course, your email address. Make sure this is the right email address you're checking a lot. Email subject line should be something you can easily recognize just like that in your mailbox. In our case, it would be new question from the website. And the from name should be our contact form. This way it is easy to recognize in your mailbox. Then the from mail is really important to make this email the exact domain as your website. If you're not using the same domain name, you will see this warning. And they're telling you to add the WP Mail SMTP plugin. But if you add in the right domain name, the message will be removed if you save it and load it again. Now the reply to email. Reply to should actually be a smart tag. Click on this one, smart tag. And we're gonna add in the field, what is your email? Why? When you're reading your email, you just wanna hit that reply button and send them back a reply. This is the way to do it, or else you will reply to your own email address. And now you will reply to the actual visitor from your website. The email messages should be all fields, great. And this is all there is to do in the free version. So we're gonna save this. And then we go over here to the confirmations. Any confirmations, you can use a message, show a page, or go to a URL as a redirect. The standard message is like this, and it will be placed inside of your page instead of the form. Works great, is very nice. However, what I actually want to use is a page. So what we need to do is need to create a thank you page, select it over here, and then you press save. If you're using a message, let's spice it up just a little bit. Thank you, smart tag, your name. Thank you, WPressDoc, for contacting us. We will be in touch with you shortly on your email address. Show smart tags, what is your email? Something like this, really great, works like a charm. Press save, and then when you fill out your form, this is the thank you message you will see. Well, this contact page is completely empty, but the form, so this is what you see. Thank you, your name, for contacting us. We will be in touch with you on the email address. If you now go to entries over here, you will see that WPForms does not store your entries in the free version. But there is a workaround. We go to plugins, add new. We're gonna search for the plugin contact form entries, just like this. And what you want to install is this one, contact form entries, WP Forms and more by CRM Perks. It's completely free and works excellent. Install it and press activate. What you now will see on the bottom, you will see CRM entries. Click on this one and here you can see all your entries from your website. Now, just dismiss this notice and you can see all the entries inside from your WP Forms. It's free, and if you press on view, for example, you can see all the answers given to them. Everything in here, you can also add some notes. It's really nice. But you can also change the columns over there. So we click on screen options. Just remove, for example, this one. And then we go with question. For example, you can just change this all around to whatever you want to show on your entry page. In this way, you will never lose any entries from WP Forms, and it's completely free. You might also want to say is, can we style this form? Of course you can, and again, it's completely free. We go to plugins, add new. Of course we can do it with CSS, but there's another fun and easier way. So look for the plugin Styler for WP Forms by Sushil Kumar. Press install now, and we're gonna press on activate. And now you can see a new item over here, Styler WP Forms, but it doesn't do anything if you click on it. This is what you see. What you want to do is go to appearance and press customize. Then you go to the page where you have your forms inside of it. And then you go to over your styler for WP Forms. If you click on it, you can press on select WP Form. We're gonna select the learn WP Form. Start styling after page refresh. So we press okay. And then the page will be refreshed. And with this plugin, you can do a lot of things, which is really easy. You can change the font family like this. To whatever font you want from the Google fonts. We can change the background color of the forms. You can even select a background image over there, like this, no problem at all. You can add borders around of your form. Another really nice feature, you can add margins, but you can also add some paddings inside of it. So now it really looks like a really nice form. If you go back over here, you can change the form headers, title, descriptions. You can change anything you want to even the submit button over there. Because the submit button is really ugly right now. So let's change it, for example, to this purple one. And when you hover over it, I want it to be this purple, for example. So using this plugin, you can create the most beautiful forms that you can imagine. Your only limitation is your creativity. If you have any questions or you just want to say thank you, Matt, drop them down in the comments. I'll always reply. Subscribe over there if you want to see more WordPress related videos, or check out this video. It has nothing to do with bears. Nothing to do with bears. Nothing.